steering assist as well, though. The little button right next to it.
This one
Yep. Turn that on. Okay, there we go. All right.
Okay.
There you go. It's doing its own thing. A little bit of a dip, but okay. It's all good.
Oh, I love Kia with their light. The light in the front and in the back, and just the way they design it.
Yeah.
It looks unique.
In the past years, they definitely stepped up their game.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. I've been around quite a bit of the car market and the car business in general. And,
yeah.
And Kia's definitely been moving in the right direction.
So do you have any knowledge about VinFast?
And then basically, once you make a right onto the street, we'll just stay in the right lane and turn right at every stoplight and it'll throw us around in a circle.
Okay, you're gonna go around in a circle then.
Mm-hmm.
You mind a test on the speed?
Absolutely. Yeah.
45.
And you have your drive modes right there to your left corner on the steering wheel. You see that? So you click on
drive mode and you switch it to.
You can click it and it'll show you in the center there.
So so you go eco. Mm-hmm. Oh, I see. So early part normal?
Yeah, or you can put it in sport.
Oh, sport, I can feel it right away. Mm-hmm. I see. What else? Okay. Very quiet.
Mm-hmm.
Advanced auto drive, anything? Auto steering, how does that?
It has the adaptive cruise control, smart base navigation adaptive cruise control.
Okay.
So it'll with the curve, so it'll turn and whatnot, and it'll keep you within the lanes.
Okay. So it can do auto steering,
not full self, but
so it's kind of like level 2, right?
Basically.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like just a simple on freeway.
Correct. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. That's my recommendation. If you're going to be using the tech that is based on self-driving,
so you can't. Can you do it in the local street like this or
you no? Can. Absolutely. You can? Yeah, right there to your steering wheel. You see that other button, one next to it?
This one.
Yep. That will read the lanes and it'll keep you within the lanes.
So it will drive for you.
Yeah, so you'd have to turn on the cruise control for this. So,
okay. I see. I'm going to try that one.
So we'll do this. And then...
Okay, so you turn on the cruise control first?
Yes. Yep, up top.
Top.
Cruise control. Hit that. Okay. And then click down to set it on the speed.
Okay.
Right there on that plus minus. The other
plus
one.
Plus minus.
Right there.
Okay.
Set it.
And then it will drive for you?
Yeah. Click down on it.
Up.
Okay. Is it set? There you go. Okay, that's it.
Did it remind you? It probably remind you to...
So turn on the steering assist as well, though. The little button right next to it.
This one here?
Yep. Turn that on. Okay, there we go. All right.
Okay.
There you go. It's doing its own thing. A little bit of a dip, but it's all good.
Does it brake for you or?
Yep, it's doing its thing.
It does?
Yep,
don't worry. Then you want to let me turn it back on again. I think I turned it off.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Did I turn it off already?
I think you turned off the cruise, yeah.
Okay.
So you got to reset it.
I see.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's on now, right?
There you go.
Mm-hmm. So am I still on the auto steering or?
You should be on the auto steering, yeah. I don't know if you're on the cruise control.
I'm on the cruise control.
Yeah, I don't see that.
Okay, now I'm on cruise control now, I think.
Yeah. Click the file page. I think that's what threw the screen off. The little
file
there's
page?
Like up top on the right.
Right here?
Yep. Yep, keep going. Keep clicking that until we get to that diagram again with the car.
Okay.
Keep going.
All right.
Huh, it disappeared.
I think it's driving right now.
Yeah, is it driving on its own?
Yeah.
So it says you have your speed set to 29 miles an hour. You see up there?
Yeah. So it does. So
that's what it's doing. Then,
does it remind you to put your hand back on or?
It will.
Okay. If you leave it too.
Yeah. If you leave it too long and it's sensing that you're going out way too much.
And it brake. I'm not braking right now.
Okay. Nope.
It brake.
Yeah, but then it's tricky on a turn.
It's tricky. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So then you have to kind of still hover your hand and feet.
Absolutely, I'll keep my eyes on
level
the road
two.
Every time.
Yeah,
you know?
Level 2. I see. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And so you have what type of EV car you have again? You have the Niro?
Niro and the EV6.
And the EV6?
Yes.
And then the EV9 is that, I heard, is that like supposed to be all electric for a Telluride?
Yes,
because the Telluride. Okay, so So EV9 is a full-size SUV.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And Telluride right now is a hybrid. Or is it like...
Telluride is just standard six-cylinder.
Oh, just standard six-cylinder.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What is your like, hybrid one? Maybe one day we'll check out the hybrid as well.
Mm-hmm. We have the Niro hybrid, which is going to be the smallest of the lineup.
Mm.
And then we have a Sportage hybrid, which is the middle. And then we have the Sorento hybrid, which is considered a subcompact third row SUV.
Okay.
So that's our biggest model we have.
Oh, I love Kia with their light in the front and in the back, and then just the way they design it.
Yeah.
It looked unique.
In the past years, they definitely stepped up their game.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
I've been around quite a bit of the car market and the car business in general. And,
yeah.
And Kia's definitely been moving in the right direction.
So do you have any knowledge about VinFast?
VinFast, I don't.
You don't?
No, not VinFast.
Is this because they don't advertise well, or?
No, I've never, I don't know, I've just never really heard of VinFast.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So how about charging? Regarding to charging, you can charge anywhere, right?
Yeah, a lot of charging stations for this one. Typically, like Electrify America is what it's called.
Okay.
That's like charging base.
Yeah, like charge point and mm-hmm. stuff like all
yes.
together.
Yep.
And where did you charge this car again? The front or the back?
In the back.
In the back.
Yeah,
okay, so similar to...
passenger side rear. Corner.
Okay, so similar to the Tesla.
Mm-hmm.
Because I know there are other companies that are charging more in the front and stuff.
Yeah, like the other model we have, the Niro, that one's in the front.
Oh, I see. So you guys kind of switch them back and forth. It's not...
Yeah.
Okay.
So
there's no really specific like model that you guys follow, like a charging station in the back or.
Yeah, I don't think Kia follows that. I mean, they just put it wherever it's makes the most sense or it's conveniently located or, you know, for that trim.
Look at
the model.
Look at the convenient the screen.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think I thought that the only Lucid has this now because I was thinking more EV are following the
mm-hmm.
one screen type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm seeing you guys keeping this, and Lucid have both. I can't say,
yeah.
You know, it makes sense because whatever the money you put in, you know, like there's a reason why it has
absolutely.
Both. But I'm saying you guys, all your electric vehicle have screen like this, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
This is kind of like Kia's new display for a few of the models.
I see.
But the electric one is definitely this.
Okay. Okay. Yeah.
And you got smart parking on this as well.
So. Okay. Can we try smart parking?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Thank you, David. Thank you for giving us this tour. Okay?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
You know, to me, I'm doing this. I'm hitting a bird with... I mean, I'm hitting one stone, killing two birds.
Yeah, one stone, two birds.
I'm also looking for an EV vehicle to replace that Honda Pilot that I have for years already. My wife already have her Tesla, so she's happy with that.
Yeah.
But, you know, I'm looking for something a little cheaper or more... manageable.
Yeah,
that's why I'm also testing it out. So how do we do that?
I'm still learning all the EVs myself.
Yeah, yeah,
given what knowledge I can.
Yep.
So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and pull in here.
Okay, pull in here.
Yep. Make a left.
Okay, you want to make a left.
So we're gonna go ahead and do
okay,
it like
we're
this.
We're gonna do the Yemen Sea Dao Parking.
We're gonna stop here.
Yeah.
And then we're gonna click this.
Okay.
And we're gonna hold it.
Okay.
Drive forward slowly, keeping closer to the side of which way you want to park.
Okay, so right now I have level 2 brake. So when I let go of the brake.
Oh, yeah, this lady here is trying to get out.
Okay.
We'll pull forward and let her out real quick.
Okay.
But yeah, it's pretty much keeping you at a
standstill. Oh, this is level 2, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So what level is like, it just completely stopped?
The iPedal, so max.
Oh, the max one.
Yes.
Okay.
That's going to be